That was an unfortunate failure in the invitational event, but try not to worry about it. At the end of the day, the championship is your most important concern.
Okay, we had the new parts come through from the factory. We'll get them on the car ahead of FP1.
Curtain rises once more then on the desert stage of Sakir as the players take their places for the opening act. Will they enthrall us like they did in 2014 with that titanic battle between Nico Rosberg and Lewis Hamilton? Well, we'll find out shortly as we get underway here in Bahrain. We'll be racing around 3.36 miles of the magnificent Bahrain International Circuit today with 15 corners and two DRS zones into turns 1 and turn 11. That should create some good passing opportunities. Keep an eye out for drivers locking the front left down into the tricky braking zone of turn 10. Joining me for today's race once again is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk briefly about Esteban Ocon. As ever, the threat of unreliability is never far away, and indeed they'll be starting out of position today due to a power unit component change. So it's going to be a difficult task to move forward from there.
Everyone has to deal with penalties or reliability issues from time to time throughout their career. You just have to suck up the pain and get on with the job at hand. Today isn't about performing a miracle to put the car back where it should be. It's about effective damage limitation.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. Sebastian Vettel has a clear track ahead of him today. He starts in pole position, and Kimi Raikkonen completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Ricciardo, Lewis Hamilton, and Bottas, a Haas, Hülkenberg, Sainz, and Kevin Magnussen, Perez, Gasly, Fernando Alonso, and Leclerc, Hartley, Ericsson, Stoffel Van Dorn, and Lance Stroll, Sirotkin, and Esteban Ocon rounds off the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Okay, the run into turn one isn't too long, so the pack will be bunched up. Take care.
Thank you.
rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. this engine mode much longer, we're about a lap over target. Drop down to mix too soon. is 2.1 seconds. Stopping now. Leading our teammate by 8.2 seconds. Okay, car ahead is now running the super soft tyre. That's the super soft on the car ahead. Our gap to first place is 15.9 seconds. Okay, clear.
Thank you.
was in first place. This is your final map, final lap of the race.
Performance from Ferrari, it hardly looked in doubt. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
Well, I'd say it's just raw pace, plain and simple. I mean, we could sit here and talk about strategy all day, the overtaking, looking after the tyres, but at the end of it all, if you want to win, you need a package that's got the speed over everyone else, and that's exactly what they had today.
So here they come now, out onto the podium. Wherever you go, anywhere in the world, the prancing horse flags are dominant in the grandstands, and they're out in force again today. It's Ferrari on the top step once more. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. Sebastian Vettel takes the lead of the Drivers' Championship. Moving on to the driver of the day then. Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
I'm going to go for Sebastian Vettel. People have suggested before that he can't race wheel to wheel, but as he showed today, it's nonsense.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Mercedes move to the top of the table. Meanwhile, Renault move up the table with another strong performance this weekend. After all this drama, you'd be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.
Amazing performance out there. You must be really happy.
You really looked in control of your car out there. Your team must be thrilled.
You gained a lot of positions during the race, didn't you? Appreciate your time.
Great work. That's exactly the kind of result I'm looking for. Keep it up. You hit your last team goal. Well done. That should get the team a nice boost to their development, and it won't hurt when it comes to your next contract review either.